Okay, these are sunflowers from the garden. Been sitting all year since last year. These 5 gallon buckets. I mean, see the sunflowers still on them? Little by little, I'm gonna take them off today. So far we got, you know, most of those are good. There's a few that are not. See all the heads I got up here? It's a very tedious thing to do it this way. A lot of people thrash them. They put them on a cloth and bang them and bang them. I'm sitting here doing it by hand. So it'll take me a few hours, what would do most people in 10 or 15 minutes. But like I said, I'm taking like a sunflower like this. First I have it hanging on me down here and just got this on, just have this thing on my chest here. After I get all that off, I have to separate all the hulls and everything from the seed. Actually, I should have probably at least half a 5 gallon bucket of seeds here when I'm done. Might get a little bit more than that actually. But see, all this is on here from last year. That's what I'm doing out here. I've showed you those torch ones. You have to use tweezers to get them out. Because, I mean, I have more than enough to do that right now, but I'm going to do it still, so I can do the border all the way back and then behind the garden, come up on the other side. Right there's the corner. And then come back up on the other side over there. You can see where the trench is. It's just like this right here. So that'd be sunflowers of and torch sunflowers, and then I'm gonna put some around the chimney right there. That little plat metal brick cement platform that comes out. That's the base of the chimney. So I'll put some there. You see, I had some grown right here. Oops, I'm going the wrong way. Where's my finger? See, I had some grown right there in between the windows, so I'm going to put some more out there too, the torch. And then, like I say, it'll attract honeybees, the large winged butterflies. That's what the torch sunflowers will. And then even hummingbirds. They really like that. So we'll have that out here for the honeybees and the large winged butterflies, and then it's also like a backup for hummingbirds. I mean, we've got feeders out here, but we want to get two more doubles, so we'll have four more feeders. And maybe we get two small ones for the garden out there, short ones. We got two short ones, but I'd like to put. See, there's a bird feeder. In the summertime, we don't use the bird feeders too much either, so we might use the ones that the bird feeders are on. There's one there. One at the other end over there. We might use those hooks for the hummingbird feeders. I would put two out there in the garden, right where the center walkway ends, right there between this number two garden and number three garden. And then same thing on the back side over there on the west side between number one and number three. Three is the long back one back there. The long garden will be back there. Number one will be that one right there, and number two right here. And three is the big long one. So we put a hummingbird feeder on both ends of the garden, right by the middle walkway. Plus the torch sunflowers all around and around the house. And it should be very, very, very plentiful for honeybees, hummingbirds, and large winged butterflies. Do the garden right there with the plastic right there, where the cinder blocks are at. I'm going to take those up and get 10 bags of potting soil and till it into that. And then put the plastic down and use those cinder blocks to like anchor it down. We used plastic over there last time, but this time it'll be raised up a little bit more. And with the cinder blocks, it's going to be like, kind of like a raised bed. Not real raised, but about 3 inches, 4 inches up. And that'll be all peppers. So right now we got, number one garden's going to have okra. And we're not sure what exactly yet. Now here we'll have our zucchini in this garden here with something else. The back will be at least five rows of tomatoes. And we've got all kinds of beans. I've got heirloom beans that I've never heard of before, but that's good still. Purple pole peas. Purple hull peas, which is a rarity, but my mom's had those. That's why I grow those. They came from her garden that she's had since she was, you know, you don't get those things down here anymore like you used to. So purple hull peas are a big one I want to get. Those might go more toward the middle of the back garden. The back garden will mainly be peas and beans. And maybe some tomatillos and definitely tomatoes. And then the far end, we're going to tuck the plastic in about 4 or 6 inches. And we're going to grow peanuts. We're going to plant three stations with three or four peanuts in each hole to grow some peanuts for this year. Thought about potatoes, but no. I got garlic started right in the middle here. I got six garlic started. I was going to do onions, but see, I got everything from seed. Everything I have is from seed. I don't have the plants. I have to do everything from seed. So it takes a lot longer and it's more difficult. So we've got about 9 tomatoes growing in the house right now, which I'll do another video on this. I'll go in there right now while this is recording. Come back out here and finish these sunflowers. Gotta get these sunflowers done, not done, but really today a lot. Oh, okay. It's 11:45. It's the 20th of March. The one that's got one line through it. This focus crap is really starting to piss me off. But, since the last video, we got all these peppers and beans peppers and tomatoes popping up now. Here we have, it looks like three peppers. See, it looks like a double one right here, growing out of the same hole. That's a peppercini. And here is a beaver dam pepper. You can see the seed on the head. See, that's what they should look like most of them. See the seed on the head of it? It's just not warm enough, I don't think. Even though we got this heat lamp on here right now. But since we've done that, this one has come up. And some more tomatoes. We've got 3 Rutger tomatoes here. One in the front here, that's the one that's like 4 inches tall. And then the one closest to the window, it's got 2 Rutger tomatoes growing in it. Right next to that is a Marglobe. That one came up. And we got one in the middle. Oh, I can't see this. You know, this. I don't need this now because the lamp is not clamped onto that. We jerry-rigged it now. Okay, let me just do it right here. All right, you know, you see this one here? Where's that? That's a Marglobe. That looks like it might be, but we're not sure about this other one either, but maybe that is right there. This is a Marglobe here. I switched them for the heat lamp. I put this one from over there, because you see there's one come here. This is a Sioux tomato. Where's that? The Sioux tomato right there. You can see the seed on top of it. All right, focus. But I put it underneath the heat lamp. Then we got Castellito. We got this one here. 4 inches tall. I'm not sure about these right here. But there's two and there's one there. We're not sure of these either. This one here is the German Johnson. And then here in the Cherokee, we've got at least one. I see the seed on it right there. And then there's a Sioux tomato right there. And that's this one here, too. I got over here for the heat. Like I said, this is the Marglobe. So And then this pepper, we don't know what it is yet. We won't know what that pepper is until it starts producing peppers. All right, so 3 weeks yesterday. 3 weeks yesterday.